TCU 30, Baylor 28. Baylor lost two turnovers. TCU only lost one. The Horned Frogs in their first game since relieving Gary Patterson of his duties, and that was a firing. Like, yep. People want to say it was a mutual parting of the ways. It was not. Gary Patterson wanted the coach, period. But TCU outgained Baylor 562 yards to 393. TCU basically put Baylor in a locker.
Yeah.
We haven't
seen anybody defensively do this to Baylor yet.
No, and honestly...
Well, like, Oklahoma State, right? Oklahoma State did it.
Yeah, Oklahoma State did it. But I am so shocked at this. Max Duggan was out for this game. This was one of my bets. This was, you know, Baylor, to this day, Baylor has never beaten TCU by more than 6 points. And yet, I bet Baylor minus 6.5. Because when I looked at the matchup, and I looked at what was going on at TCU, and I realized... at this Baylor offense against that run defense, and TCU doesn't have Duggan, and Zach Evans, like, what, you know, there was so much there that looked like it was going to go Baylor's direction. But Chandler Morris, who, by the way, do you know who Chandler Morris's dad is?
No.
Chad Morris, former Arkansas coach. Chandler Morris comes in, first start, freshman. I mean, he is like... He was ridiculous. Like, I don't even know what that was. This game should not have been close. How about Jerry Kill, by the way? Awesome, awesome debut as head coach at TCU in his interim status. But Chandler Morris, 29 out of 41, 461 yards, two touchdowns. Chandler Morris carried the ball 11 times for 70 yards and a touchdown. He was awesome. He was absolutely awesome. People jumped in the chat, by the way. Niasaur L said, "I can't wait until my dogs play Bama. Bryce Young is going to fold." Bama ain't going to be there.
Yeah, they are.
they're not going to be
there. You think A&M will go win out?
I do. Okay. Yeah. A&M is really good. We're going to talk about them in a minute.
But I agree with that statement, but... And I still think they could find a loss somewhere around here, too.
You're probably right. And Gary Lewis tossed up the peace sign and said, "This content is great." Well, we certainly appreciate that. Give me your thoughts on TCU here, because this was a different TCU team. I will say this. I know people that are around the TCU program, and nobody talked about it beforehand, but after the game yesterday, they said it was evident that that team had, you hate to use the quit word, but it looked like that team had quit under Patterson. And then you get a breath of fresh air in this game. Like, maybe this was the dead cat bounce, right? Where they have this one amazing game and a rivalry game, and then they'll come back down to earth next week. But this looked like a team that was rejuvenated in losing its head coach.
Yeah, you might be right. I didn't see that coming. But I also thought, even if TCU comes out and plays great, Baylor has just been so good on both sides of the football that I just didn't see them playing. I didn't see them giving up 30 points. I just didn't. I thought this game could be played in the mid-20s, but I also kind of thought they were going to score mid-30s. And so I kind of thought Baylor by 10, Baylor by, you know, two touchdowns.
That's what I thought.
And I just, because I haven't seen anybody slow them down. Now, they scored 28 points, but in today's football world, that ain't enough. It's just not. And I was surprised that TCU got to 30. I just was. Zach Morris, Jesus.
Morris.
Chandler Morris. And 90s kid right here. I just didn't – I didn't see this from their offense. TCU's offense has been explosive all year, but Baylor's defense outside of Oklahoma State has been the second-best defense in that conference. I thought they would stand up. I thought they would make a statement. And they just got.
Seth Garcia jumped in and said Oklahoma might run the table. I don't have Oklahoma State on here to talk about, but Oklahoma State, when I say somebody put somebody in a locker, Oklahoma State did not allow West Virginia to do anything. Now,
let's be real careful before we just chalk up next week, too, yeah, because I know we're talking about Baylor and a loss in this situation. That could have been a look-ahead spot.
It's entirely possible, because TCU had not shown the ability to do this. You talked about TCU being explosive all year. Yes, but not to this level. They weren't doing it consistently. No. And
not against this opponent either.
Right, right.
Like, they look great against Texas Tech. You know, like, they put up big numbers against bad defenses all day long. They hadn't played a great defense yet, you know?
Yeah, you're right about that. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, @GaryWCE, @ChrisBGiannini, @winningcures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.